Once upon a time, not too long ago, a skirmish broke out among a wretched mass of humanity. Chaos reigned within the mob where supporters of the three holidays, Christmas, Hanukkah, and Kwanzaa, argued over the holiday they think surpasses all others.
Have you seen all the fighting that's been going on?
I have, and it's getting completely out of hand.
I agree. We should totally do something about that.
Well, what if we just put them all together and told them they shouldn't be fighting?
I don't think that will solve it completely.
Well, what if we just put together our holiday traditions?
Some of our traditions.
As the night went on, the three wise elders talked and chose which traditions they thought would be best for their new holiday. As morning dawned, the elders finally got a list of traditions that they wanted in their new holiday.
Finally, done with the list. What should we name this?
What if we call it Chris Quantica?
I like that.
I like that. Attention, everybody. Attention!
So everybody, we've decided that we're sick and tired of everyone arguing about the holidays.
So we decided to create a new holiday that combines portions of all of our traditions.
So with this new holiday, we've decided to call it
Chris Kwanzaa.
So we'll be hosting a big holiday dinner.
And we invite all of you to come feast with us.
To an amazing new holiday.
So after a while of trying to figure out how they were going to resolve the issue of which holiday was better and making a new holiday, everybody was able to come together and agree on a new holiday.
Hello, and welcome to the winter edition of 3TV. I'm Brianne Popowell.
And I'm Kayla Mathias.
Today we will be hearing from Jack Hernandez interviewing Ms. Sunderman about the upcoming Washington, D.C. trip, Kaden Wright bringing us the Ugly Sweater Fashion Show, and Kaylee Jude in the Commons.
On January 19th, 43 students will be headed to the nation's capital to witness the inauguration of the 45th President of the United States, Donald Trump. Here's Jack Hernandez and Ms. Sunderman discussing the trip.
Hi, I'm Jack Hernandez, and today I'll be interviewing Mrs. Sunderman about the class trip to the presidential inauguration in Washington, D.C. in January. So, Ms. Sunderman, what kind of things do you think the students will learn on the upcoming trip?
I think that they will hopefully learn a little bit more about the history of Washington, D.C. and the history of a lot of our important political leaders through all the monuments and museums. And I'm hoping they get to learn a little more about how government actually works and what democracy really looks like when it's put into action.
What about the trip makes it worthwhile to you?
I think having the opportunity to spend time with a group of seniors who I've had in class before will be a lot of fun. I think it'll be very memorable for all of us. But really, to be able to go and see a president be inaugurated and to be on the Washington Mall and to be around all of the celebration and all of the excitement and really seeing a new administration take off, I think will make it certainly worthwhile.
Why do you think the trip will be a highlight for some high school students?
I think because it's their senior year and most of them have taken government, so they kind of already understand a lot of the things that they're going to be seeing. But it seems like we have a lot of groups of friends going, and I think anytime you can go and take an exciting trip with some of your high school friends, it'll be really memorable. And hopefully they'll have a lot of memories and a lot of fun things to talk about afterwards.
How does going to the inauguration in person differ from other learning sources?
When you're there in person, there'll be such a energy because there'll be thousands and thousands of people around us. It'll be very exciting to see it firsthand and to be able to see all of the congressmen and women and the Supreme Court justices and to be able to hear the swearing in firsthand as opposed to watching it on TV. We also won't have the words of commentators when you watch it on TV to kind of skew our vision of it. We'll be able to come up with our own conclusions and kind of interpret it for ourselves.
Sounds like a good trip filled with lots of educational opportunities. Thanks for the interview, Mrs. Sunderman. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Jack. The trip is now only 35 days away. Did you know only 31 days after becoming president in 1841, William Henry Harrison died of a pneumonia he contracted at his inauguration? So be sure to wear your layers and dress warm.
And now we'll be tuning into the Ugly Sweater Fashion Show with your host, Kaden Wright.
Thanks, Brianne. Welcome to the first ever Toll's Ugly Sweater Fashion Show. We wanted to take something fun but stick with the holiday theme. Let's get started.
Oh look, the sheep wore a Christmas sweater too.
the crazy cat lady came out to play. This look was brought to you by a homeless woman. She's getting lit this Hanukkah. Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we had today, but this was a lot of fun. I think we all look good for any kind of holiday party you have. So back to you, Brianne.
Those were quite the ugly sweaters. Maybe Santa will bring them a better one this year. Next, we'll hear from Kaylee Jude in the Commons interviewing people about the holidays.
Hello, I'm Kaylee Jude, and welcome to In the Commons. Today, I'll be walking around the Commons, asking students questions regarding the upcoming holidays. What are your plans for holiday break?
I plan on staying home with my mom because she's getting knee replacement surgery done.
I don't know, probably go visit my grandparents, stay home, do whatever.
To get as much housework done as possible and enjoy Christmas.
Well, I plan to sleep in, catch up on some sleep because I work so hard to market and provide for you students every single day that I'm here. And so that's what I plan to do. I plan to catch up on my sleep mainly.
I plan on traveling down to Oklahoma just for the stuffs and giggles.
I might be going to Disney World, actually, so I hope for that.
I'm going to spend lots of time with my grandkids and clean out kitchen cupboards and read books.
So I will be traveling to Chicago for Christmas and visiting family and then going to Pittsburgh for New Year's.
What's the most unusual gift you've ever received?
I can't say I've ever got any unusual gifts because I basically get what I want.
I would have to say a sham wow.
I always just got what I wanted. I don't think I've had an unusual gift before.
Pancakes.
Gag toys. In the stockings. Just like the flarp stuff.
I received a box once. Nothing in it, just a box.
Probably the most unusual gift I've ever received is receiving no gift. Because I think most that's unusual, that the fact that people don't want to give me gifts.
What's your favorite holiday food?
Mashed potatoes.
Probably all the different cookies.
Oh, I really love peppermint stick ice cream. Like, love it.
Pie. Definitely pie.
What makes you most excited about holiday break?
It's really bad of me to say this, but I love presents.
It's a time where everybody gets to take a break, a well-deserved break, a couple weeks off. You get to be with family and friends and get to relax, and you don't have to worry about all of life's pressures and stresses.
Break from school. Definitely.
As you saw, everyone has many different opinions and all seem very excited about the holidays. I'm Kaylee Jude and I hope you have happy holidays and safe travels. Thank you for watching. See you all next year. Now back to the studio.
What a diverse group of students we have here at Tolles. Before we go, here are some important dates to remember.
Winter break is Wednesday, December 21st to Tuesday, January 3rd. January 13th is a professional development day, which means no school for students. There is also no school January 16th because it's Martin Luther King Jr. Day. The Washington, D.C. trip is Thursday, January 19th to Monday, the 23rd.
President's Day is January 20th, so there will not be school. There is ACT testing at Tolles on February 11th, so make sure to sign up soon. There is another professional development day on February 17th, and there will be no school. Make sure to keep up on your grades because the end of the third 9 weeks is March 10th. Each year, Tolles hosts a senior interview contest where all of the seniors compete in a mock job interview complete with a resume and portfolio. On November 30th and December 1st, professionals from all kinds of businesses interviewed over 300 Tolles seniors. Your top eight interview winners were Tori Popp from Digital Media Production, Callie Kawa from Pre-Vet Tech, Katie Dickey from Pre-Nursing, Shandon Feldick from Computer Networking and Support, Brianna Holder from Marketing and Logistics, Casey Carner from Engineering and Manufacturing, Casey Swaggerty from Firefighting and EMS, and Tamara Vega from Art Design Communications. The final winners will be announced before winter break.
I'm Brianne.
And I'm Kayla. This has been the winter edition of 3TV.
Have a great winter break. See you in January.